everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a set of nails with the builder in a bottle, but we're not just going to do a normal set, we're going to do a French ombre. Do you know what French ombre is, Annette?
Nope. But I'm about to learn.
You are about to learn what a French ombre is. I've already prepped Annette's nails. I'm just going to wipe over because she's been in the toilet and I don't know if she's washed her hands.
She's one of them, is
she? She's bare, isn't she? Chubby nails without washing them.
So, we will need the base coat. That needs to go on first. And we're going to choose some colours to do this French ombre with. So, this is weird. I have a camera there, and another one there. A bit weird there.
Just messing around, yeah. Just a little bit.
So, we'll need Jack Frost. See, this is the white. This is Snow White gel polish. This is Build in the Bottle Jack Frost. So you can see though it's not like a brilliant white, and that's kind of what you need really when you're doing a French ombre. You don't want something that's like a brilliant white. I say brilliant white because that's what you get in the paint shop, don't you? When you go for some paint for your walls. So we'll need that, and we will need, where is Poltergeist? The many, many colours. So we have Poltergeist, which is a transparent kind of milky colour. There's a similar one which is Insomnia, but it is a little bit. Look at just. Shall we have a little look at the difference? Let's put that on there.
That's so which one's that one?
Insomnia, and this one is Poltergeist. Insomnia slightly whiter. So we've got Poltergeist, Jack Frost. We've got the base, and then we need a colour to do this natural sort of colour at the back. And let's just have a little look. See, I think that's too much colour. You know what I mean?
Too pink.
Too, yeah. And especially like this kind of colour as well. Too pink. Yeah, we're going to use rose quartz. I was going to try and use a different one, but I do just really like that colour. It's like my favourite one. What I have on my nails. I have it on, but I have some of the chrome flakes on top as well, just to give it a bit of a pizzazz, make them a bit special. You're going to dehydrate the nails with the nail prep dehydrator. Going to use the base coat now. Just want a nice thin layer on that natural nail. This is going to help adhere everything. So it's going to be long lasting. Pop me them in the lamp.
Going to do the same like that, aren't you?
I was going to do it all like
that. I'm pointed on chubby nails.
So you can, if it was pointed like that, long, yes, you can get away with that on chubby nails.
Because it's so long. You've done pointed on me before then.
But not short. That'd look weird.
Yeah, slightly longer than that. Not as long as that, because I could never handle nails that long. I would pick my nose and wipe my backside.
All at the same time.
With the same hand. Never a dull moment with you, Kirsty.
Right, bring me that out the lamp. I'm going to put the forms onto the fingers. I'm not going to do the thumb. I'm going to do the thumb. And I'm not doing the thumb because of the angle that the thumb sits at. It's on its side. I don't want this gap here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tailor the form. The nail, so it comes up and fills that gap. That makes sense. when you look at that, you go, what?
Do I?
That fits a lot better now. And it was literally that much. That's all that I cut out. And it made such a big difference. So we're going to start with Jack Frost. I've got the product on one side of the brush. And I'm going to start at the end. Just moving side to side to lay that product down to get some length. We're going to wipe off the excess and tickle it up a little bit. Feather that up a little bit. Gel brush just to neaten up the sides a little bit. And put me that in the lamp. Now I'm going to put a thin layer of Poltergeist over that. And I'm going to use it to add a little bit of thickness through here. Just tickling that. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Pop me that in the lamp. Now I'm going to use the Rose Quartz. At the back here, guiding that with the brush where I want it. And then we're going to go side to side, bring that down. You want to sort of feather it out. Turn your hand over. Then with Poltergeist, you're going to go from about 3/4 of the way up. Just lay that down thin, and then we want to come side to side, bring that down right to the tip. Turn it over. In the lamp. So a few different layers, and doing it in those layers will give you that ombre. So you've got the white, and then you've got this sort of natural nudie colour coming over, and the Poltergeist helps to blend and create that sort of fogged effect. Then I'm going to use clear as day and go over the entire nail. It's going to give it loads of structure. In the lamp. You can pop the pinching tool on and give that a little bit of a pinch while it's cooling. It'll just pinch. So we're going to repeat that on the rest of the nails. Thank you. So you can see why we're going to do the thumb last, so we can get a good position rather than it being just worrying about the other nails. Right, so we lay down quite a bit there, so we can just start to move this around and start to tease it back. What you can do is use a gel brush, just blend that back a bit and get your sides nice. It will move in the lamp, you need to be aware of that. Turn your hand over for me. In the lamp, thin layer of Poltergeist. Pop that into the lamp. I do love this rose quartz, I think it's a gorgeous colour. Side to side. And just blend it in. Pop that in. Right, let's just blend this back a little bit. Turn it over. And then you can pop it in the lamp. Fine. So, wiping over with gel residue wipe off solution. And I can actually give that nail a little bit of a pinch while it's cooling. Just with my fingers. It doesn't need a massive pinch really because, you know, it's only a short nail. So let's file. I'm going to use my 180 grit file. It's very easy to file. Side walls, and we're going to do that cuticle area and contour it so it doesn't look like a pebble. Yeah, you'll find that gel dust is a lot finer. So I'm going to use a buffer now to just buff over, smooth them off, get rid of your sharp corners. Let's use the gel residue wipe off solution, give them a wipe over. We make them nice and clean and then we can top coat. That looks very natural. Ish.
They're really pretty.
So urban graffiti top coat. In the lamp. So I'm going to finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil. I've got the tea tree cuticle oil here. Let's rub that in.
I absolutely love that.
Love them.
Mm-hmm.
Classy, aren't they?
Yeah.
Get them off, Annette. They don't suit you.
Keep the insults going.
Just paying you back for all the insults you've kept me over the years.
I've started coming up with some new ones.
Yeah. Cute little French ombre, bit of baby boomer going on there. I am. Hope you've enjoyed this video as much as Annette is loving her nails. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today, so all the builder and the bottle gels, will be listed below in the description box. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Now, I would definitely say it's not as wide. Oh, for God's sake. Oh my God, it's on the Uggs. Have you ever got gel polish on a pair of trainers before? I have.
It didn't come off.
Oh, no.
So in this video, we're going to do a tutorial of how to remove gel polish from trainers. Gel residue wipe off solution, and we hope that that is going to take it out.
You know what we should also do? Do a tutorial on how to put lids back on bottles.
I thought that was hard.
They're like a suede, aren't they?
No, suede. It's not. No, it's like a scuba kind of.
Scuba?
Scuba. Scuba diving.
Like wetsuit.
Yeah, kind of fabric. I think I'm going to knock the trainer if I do it anymore. I think that's going to have to do.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how to get gel polish off a trainer that's like a scuba suit.
Never!